this tutorial, I am going to show you how you can read a file and write in a text box, and read from text box and write it to another file. And for this, I am going to use the two buttons, double click on the first, and I am going to use read and also label read, and the second I am going to use write and also write, and initially I am going to use it dimmed, that it is not activated, that nobody can by mistake use the write first, that we are going to get error otherwise. I am going to select the read and callback function, and in C file I am going to delete the unnecessary events. I'm going to move it under my callback functions here, and this one must be okay. What I need here is a character S of long 100, and I need a file name of the length P, which is defined up there, and I need a integer M lines, line and I, and I am going to write here all those first, these ones, all those, these ones, I am going to copy and paste here, and when I am opening, I am going to use the same I must use the same, all of them is the same, and if close, copy V, and after that I am going to use when I am finished with reading and writing here, I need to write the context of this file in another file, and that is because I must make it undimmed, and you are going to use as set control P, set control attribute, use that one, select, and it is the ID is our text box, which is here, UCO, and I am going to attribute not label, only the button button. Cancel it, and here it is not text box, it is our command button. Command button 17, and I am going to use not the label, this one dimmed, attribute dimmed, and the value is 0. It's going to make it visible, and I am going to use Control I. And the next step is that we are going to define file pointed EFP and pointed UFP. It must be pointer UFP, and I am going to use here UFP foo pen. It's equal foo pen F file name. And for write, and before that I must use those functions to use another file V. You can use the same file name or you can declare another file name, it doesn't matter, it's change it automatically. And I am going to use this one. After that, Control X, Control V, we open the file to write, and we are going to use get num. Get num. Control P. Num text box lines. And the panel handle is the R panel handle here. Uko. And the ID. ID is text box, and the count, it must be put it in line, and Control I. I have the file line, and put the result in that variable, and I am going to use for I equals 0, I less than line, plus plus I. I am going to Control Z. I am going to use get Control P. Get text box long. Get transfer is RS, control EI, and it is S here, and it is correct. The index is the loop index, and I am going to use fprint f UFP with format string new line, and I am going to put the context of S. It's get text box line, it's reading each line of text box with the index I, and put it in the variable S, which is the character of 100 length, and then I am going to print to the file fprintf. It means that it prints, writes to the file, and that file is UFP, which is open for writing, and with format string, and fill it. And then I am going to use fclose UFP, and I am going to reset text box, and I am going to use reset text box select, and the panel handle is our panel handle in this program, and the ID is our text box, which we want to reset it, and what we want replace the context of text box, I am going to use it empty. Now we are going to compile. Okay, I find about my mistake now. I need this part in right when I am going to select the right button, and I am going to select this one and control callback. I am going to remove all those things, extra events, unnecessary events. I am going to remove it under callback functions, and I am going to delete all those things, or take it from here and remove it here, and I am going to use the same copy and paste here. the write has been undimmed, it is activated. Now I am going to use write. I am going to use another file, me, and everything is written in my file, and it is and make the text box empty. Now I am going to check both files, open. The first is here, and the second, we have put each line, we have deferred each line with an empty line, and all the context is correct. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.